I'm Emilie, and this is my mum, and today we're going to make a story.
What would you like to make a story about?
The virus, to thank the doctors and nurses.
Yes. How are we going to begin the story?
How would it feel for a doctor to have so many sick people? It could be about a family that has to stay at home because of the virus.
That's it. So, you want the story to be about a family like ours that has to stay at home?
Yes.
What other idea have you got for the story?
There could be a dog in it.
What's the dog gonna be called?
Spock. Perhaps Pip. Do you think Pip is a nice name?
Yes, he's very nice.
I think the little girl will be sad without cuddling her daddy.
What's the little girl gonna be called?
Emily, because it's called Emily's Blackboard Adventures.
So, you wanted it to be a true story?
Yes, because we know what it feels like, because we had to stay at home too.
So, what do you miss most about staying at home?
I miss my friends at Elephant's World, Cha-Cha's The One, Pierre, Maplan, SMO, all those kind of friends. Maybe we can explain how to help each other, like tying a stick to a flower. We can support each other like a stick. Now my rose is gonna grow up straight.
What kind of naughty things can Pip do in the story?
I know. Come on, I show you. Spock! Maybe Pip could be chewing the table leg. Nom nom nom. Maybe Pip could be chewing the curtains. Maybe Mummy could patch them up. He could be chewing the shoe. Mm-hmm. Pip could chew a book too. Normally, I do homeschooling, so I know what it feels like. My favorite activity is drawing and making up stories. In my real life, I have 6 dogs, and my story is just one. In our story, Pip likes making mischief. In real life, my dogs are well behaved. My black dog is called Jack. He's scared of everything. My little dog is called Spock. My dog Sharky is so soft and adorable, but sometimes when there's a dog in the swamp, he barks. We have a very old dog called Sunday. He's from France. She's 17 years old and she sleeps all the time. In real life, my dad is an artist. He plays piano too. He's a musician. I'm going to imagine my dad is a doctor and imagine what that would be like for him and for me. In real life, my mom is an artist, and it's true, she paints animals every day. I like helping my mom coloring the pictures. It's useful because I'm left-handed and my mom is right-handed, so we make a good team. We had to do some rough sketches first of all, just to work out the ideas. The ratio of the paper is 60 by 9, which is the ratio of the video. Because we can't go out, we can draw each other for the story. I am modeling for my mom. I want to tell a story about my friendship with my dog, which is easy because I have so many dogs in real life. Sometimes dogs are real characters. They always give you love. If you're kind to them, no matter what they do, never hit them. They'll be a true friend for life. I got 6 friends. They are all my best friends. The scenes in our story are just around our house. At the back of our house, there's a big swamp. It would be nice if we had some flowers too, so I'm making a garden. I got to use pots because we don't have very much land. So in our story, I'm dreaming that I have a big garden and I'm going to plant sunflowers because they're radiant and golden and make me feel happy when I see them. Now all our drawings are done. Mommy's worked very hard, sometimes in the night. Now I got to scan them all. It's pretty easy. Once I scanned the picture, I invert it in Photoshop, change the levels and the saturation until it looks exactly opposite of the real drawing. That's to say, it will look like it's a drawing on a blackboard, which is an effect I like. The colors look bright next to black instead of white. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. My name is Emilie.
Good.
I like recording audio and I have my own microphone from Uncle Paul. It's called Hype Mic, which I'm using right now. Wagging Tales of the Unexpected. Story and narration by Emilie Barton, 5.5 years old, and Dad. That's my dad behind me cooking dinner. He loves to cook when he's home, which is not very often because he's a hospital doctor and always super busy. When we're all together as a family, it's the greatest thing in the world. My mom is an artist. She's kind and patient. She paints people's pets. It smells scrumptious, thought Pip the dog, licking his whiskers. I hope I get some too. On the news, they call the virus a pandemic. Pandemics are the worst of the worst. Dad talked to me again on FaceTime. He looks very tired. He had to stay at the hospital. Dad said I had to stay at home and look after Mum. The next day, Pip was waiting by the door with his lead in his mouth. He was excited to go for a walk. Sorry, Pip, we can't go out today. It's gonna be like this for a very long time. Let's go out into the garden instead. Pip went to the window instead. A bird sang happily. We can support each other and the doctors and nurses by keeping our distance from each other and wearing masks when we are together. These are little things we can do to save lives. The video editor is Final Cut Pro 10. It's really easy to use. Dad and me edit our videos together. I like to tell a story using video or with drawings. The music in our video is from the audio library. It's copyright free. I've chosen the music that I like best for our story. Hello, I'm Emilie. I wrote this story with my dad. It's a story we never expected to write. It sounds made up, but it's true. It's not set in any particular place. It could be anywhere. It's about the past few months staying at home with my family and dog. It's to say thank you to our heroic doctors and nurses and their families. It's about lifting up and supporting those in need. It's about the simple things we can do together to give our unfinished story an ending. Thanks for watching. Please stay safe and well.